This session at ESMO was devoted to analyze the optimal response criteria in multiple myeloma. As I introduced, until year 2000, we reported the response for myeloma patients in terms of overall response rate. That means partial response or better. And the reason was because we have very few drugs, very few effective drugs, apart from melphalan, and the rate of complete responses was very low, less than 5%. But this changed dramatically in the last two decades with the introduction of immunomodulatory drugs, proteasome inhibitors, monoclonal antibodies, complete change in the paradigm for myeloma treatment. And now, a substantial proportion of patients achieve complete response. But we have also realized that complete response is a definition that is suboptimal and confusing for patients. Suboptimal because it based on parameters of low sensitivity, immunofixation, and the morphology of the plasma cell. To have 3% plasma cells means complete response. But are these plasma cells normal? Or are still clonal, myelomatose? With morphology, you cannot distinguish. And with immunohistochemistry, the sensitivity is low, 10 to the minus 2. On top of this, the term complete response is confusing for patients. They understand complete response, but it's incomplete response, unfortunately. It's like an iceberg. You have a lot of disease below the surface of the water. And these are the MRD techniques, those that go in depth to try to identify residual tumor cells in the patient. And we have developed now, and we have available two techniques, one based on the antigenic characteristics of the cell. This is the immunophenotyping, the flow cytometry, the next generation flow, the last development for flow, and we have the molecular biology, the next generation sequencing. Both techniques allow you to detect one malignant cell among a million normal cells, and both techniques has clearly demonstrated that in transplant eligible, non-transplant eligible, relapse patient, standard risk, high risk, whatever the subpopulation you analyze, if you remain MRD positive, the chances to have a prolonged progression-free survival are significantly shorter than if you achieve an MRD negativity, particularly in the range of 10 to the minus 6. Is this enough? No. Because you may have a false negative result due to inadequate bone marrow sampling, a more diluted, or because the sampling has not gone to an area of extramedullary disease. This is why these techniques need to be complemented with imaging technique. Imaging techniques based mainly on the PET. And both together is the way to analyze the optimal way to analyze the response that is achieved with the new effective drugs that we are using currently for multiple myeloma. And this is the only pathway to achieve our final goal, that is to cure a substantial proportion of our myeloma patients. Thank you very much.